everyone. Hey, everyone. You know, I am just, anyway, a little bit about myself is my name is Stewart. And, if you just saw that, that really awesome video that I just edited, well, all I have to say is congratulations. You know, that's awesome. You know, that's just showing off my good, video production skills that I had at my high school. And I have to tell you guys, my school year, even though I'm a junior, was just unfortunately not the best. You know, there was a lot of bad, but a lot of hilarious moments and all, and a lot of stuff. And so then, you know, I know the last time I was in school was my last day, and things are kind of quiet. I saw my best friend Aaron Samuels, and I saw it with Katie Herron and Regina George and Gretchen Wieners and all that stuff. But unfortunately, my school year did not start out like that. No. It did not start out like that. But I will tell you about it right now. And this is my root beer. And anyway, I will tell you about it right now. So anyway, the first day of school, my junior year, was not very, very good, you know. There was a lot of craziness going on, you know. And I was just going into school, like always, with my books and my backpack and all that stuff. And so then, you know, as I was, you know, walking into school, I saw this one beautiful and stunning girl that had red hair. And she was kind of nervous. And her name was Katie Herron, I believe. I'm pretty sure I did not pronounce her name right, but anyways, I saw her going into school, and she was just kind of nervous, you know, because there was maybe two African American students that were burning up, you know, some homework or recent homework that they got. And so anyways, you know, she was walking into her first class, and you know, and unfortunately, a lot of the students were telling her, you know, where to sit, where not to sit, and then there was this one gothic girl named Janice, and then she had this other one companion named Damien, you know, and unfortunately, I kind of found out that he, well, is not straight, you know, and I think he might be gay, but anyway, and so anyway, then what happened was, you know, as Katie was looking for a seat, you know, then she bumped into Miss Norbury, I believe, and the thing about Miss Norbury is that she wears brown hair, and she, you know, and so anyway, Katie bumped into her, and she had to change out of her shirt, and then all of a sudden, Principal Duvall walked in and saw Miss Norbury in a bra, you know, and so then, you know, and then Principal Duvall was just kind of checking her out from head to toe and all that stuff, and so it was just kind of funny, you know, and so then what happened was I was just sitting at my desk, and so then Katie Herron sat with Janice and Damien and all this stuff, and they were kind of introducing each other. And then there was this one guy that walked by Janice. He was like, "Hey, Janice, what's it made of?" And Janice was like, "Your mom's just here!" And then she was like, "I'm Janice." And then Katie introduced herself, telling who she was. And so, anyways, so they kind of spent a lot of time with each other and all that stuff. And anyway, keep in mind, this was actually the Katie Herron's second day at my high school. And so anyways, then, you know, Katie was spending time with Damien, and all of a sudden, you know, Janice was all of a sudden telling the story about the plastics. And don't get me wrong, like, when I'm walking in the hallways, you know, I'm checking out the plastics all the time, especially Regina George, you know, man. And my God, I mean, Regina George, she is just a very beautiful and stunning girl. Even though there's a couple other girls that I hit on at my high school, but there's just something about Regina George and Gretchen Wieners and that other blonde girl that I can't really know her name, but she's very beautiful and very stunning as well. And so, anyways, then little did Katie know, actually, believe it or not, Katie and I both skipped our sex education class, you know, with Coach Carr, and all of a sudden, you know, I was just listening to my to my iPod, I believe, and Coach Carr was giving his, you know, sex education lecture, going like, don't have sex, you know, because you will get pregnant and die, you know, don't do the standing up, don't do the, you know, just don't do it. And then all of a sudden, he was handing out free condoms to the other students and all that stuff, which was kind of silly, you know, but it was kind of a good thing as well, because there are some pretty crazy people at my high school, you know, especially in the lunchroom. And that is where I will tell you guys about that part right now. So anyways, you know, then, you know, the next day, Caddy was looking for a seat, you know, at lunch. And then, you know, that's where she ran into the Plastics and Regina George and Gretchen Wieners. Oh, and Karen Smith as well. I finally got to finding out her name. I was looking in my yearbook, you know, and I finally found Karen Smith's name. Anyway, back to the story. Caddy was sitting by the Plastics, and before that, you know, there was this one guy named Jason. And the thing about Jason is I've hung out with the guy a couple times, and unfortunately, he's kind of unfortunately not very smart. And I was kind of overhearing, you know, the conversation that, you know, they were having, and how Jason was trying to be friendly, but actually, in reality, he was actually trying to hit on Caddy Heron. Anyways, Caddy Heron then sat by the Plastics, and all three girls started asking Caddy questions, you know, just because Caddy lived in Africa and all that stuff, Caddy was sitting with the Plastics and all that stuff, and they were talking. And so, anyway, then what happened was I saw Caddy go into the women's bathroom, you know, and I was just kind of checking out Caddy Heron and all that stuff. And little did I know, as I was walking back to my, my fourth period, I saw Damien go into the women's bathroom as well. I know that kid has been in detention like 7 billion times, but I guess now, you know, I guess people just know about him too much to the point where people just don't want to do anything about it. Anyways, I was just walking and I was hearing, you know, Caddy Heron talking to Janice and Damien, and Janice was saying like, Regina George is not sweet, you know. You know, she ruined my life, you know. And so then, you know, then all of a sudden, then, like, there was this one girl that got out of the woman's bathroom, and Damien started chasing her, and then he got, you know, and so then all of a sudden, you know, then he, you know, he then went into Principal Duvall's office, and then he got in detention. Okay, that's unfortunately not what really happened, even though that probably would make you guys laugh, you know. And all that stuff. But then you guys would be like, Stewart, you know, Damien did not chase after that girl that looked like Danny DeVito. You're making that stuff up. And yeah, you're right. I kind of made that up. But anyways, the next day, you know, Caddy Heron, you know, she didn't really have anything pink, I believe. And so then what happened was, Janice said, no, she did not have anything pink. And so then Damien said, yes. Anyways, the next school day, you know, she was in math, Caddy Heron was in math, and it just so happens that I was in that same math class, and I struggle with math like crazy in that class. I don't really know why. I'm not very good at calculus or algebra. I mean, and I think, too, the last time I had my IQ tested, I think I had an IQ of only 40, and I swear to God, I probably should be in special education, I believe, just because of that, you know. And, you know, and unfortunately, I've been in detention for 30 times just because I've been checking out a lot of girls at my high school. Anyway, not important. But anyways, you know, then Aaron Samuels, you know, he didn't have a pencil or anything. So that is when Caddy actually caught, you know, Aaron Samuels' eye. And I actually hang out with Aaron Samuels a couple times, and he's actually a pretty cool guy as well, you know. Like, he plays a lot of sports and plays football and all that stuff. And And yeah, like I've talked to Aaron Samuels a couple times. He's a pretty cool dude. He actually gave me these sunglasses, believe it or not. You know, he actually gave it to them for me as a birthday gift, you know, even though I don't know how I'm part of his popular clique, even though my IQ is like only 30. Only 30%, and I don't even know how I'm going to public schooling. Anyways, you know, Katie was walking, about to walk home, and then Regina George, you know, drove up, and then she said to Katie, like, get in, loser, we're going shopping, you know, just like all the other popular girls at my high school. Anyways, they started going to the mall, and they were, and for some reason, you know, everything in the mall that Katie was walking by, it reminded her a lot of Africa, like in her head, you know, and it just so happened too, you know, when Katie, you know, before that, you know, when Regina George was, you know, driving to the mall, I actually snuck into her car, you know, like while her trunk was open, you know, I was like, okay, I gotta see what these girls are up to. And so I dived into her trunk, and then she closed the trunk. And so anyways, you know, and so Katie Heron, Regina George, and Karen, they did not know I was there. Anyways, and so anyways, Katie was imagining all the African animals, you know, like all the monkeys and the elephants, and picturing them as humans, I believe. And so then what happened was, you know, then Gretchen Wieners was like, oh my God, there's Jason! And so he was, and unfortunately, you know, Jason was dating this one girl and all that stuff. And so then all of a sudden, Regina George was not very pleased about it, to the point where she even called the Planned Parenthood on her cell phone, you know, and called the girl's mom. And she even faked the part where the girl had, you know, the pregnancy test, even though there was no results of her being pregnant. And all of a sudden, the mom fainted on the phone, and unfortunately, you know, then the mom called, you know, Jason's girlfriend and all that stuff, and then, anyways, I was at the mall too, you know, I was looking around, like, other stuff, such as, like video games, like, seeing if they had the latest GameCube game out, or, you know, I was actually playing basketball in the gym, and all that stuff, you know, I just looked at very different places in that particular mall. But the next part would be even more crazy, and I will tell you about it in the next part of the story. But what happened was, you know, after they went to the mall, they then started heading to Regina George's house. And this is where, you know, Katie, you know, unfortunately kind of finds out about the burn book, you know, which unfortunately is now, the burn book unfortunately is a book where unfortunately Regina George makes fun of a lot of, you know, girls at the school and calls them a lot of really bad and very, very rude names. And I cannot express to tell you about it, you know, it's just very, very awful. You know, if you're one of those people at my high school that, you know, that never sees the burn book, consider yourself very lucky, you know. And if you weren't part of the, all wild fight where all the girls at my high school were fighting like African animals, you know, and all because of the burn book, you know, if you were part of that, you know, that was kind of bad too, but I'll get to that very soon in my story. Anyways, the first thing that happened was Regina George noticed, you know, that, you know, actually not Regina George, but Katie found out, you know, that Regina George's mom, you know, unfortunately she wore a lot of sweat clothing. I don't think she even wore anything under her track jacket, you know, no bra or nothing, you know, which is, that actually kind of sounds very, very interesting, you know. I would love to date a girl like that. Anyways, you know, back on the story, you know, she meets, you know, Regina George's mom, and unfortunately she finds out that they were serving them, you know, cocktails or martinis that had alcohol, I believe, in them. Anyways, you know, Katie finds out about the burn book and all that stuff, and finds out what the plastics were like and all in Regina's bedroom and all that stuff. And so anyways, once, you know, then I found out too that there was a Halloween party, you know, at one of Aaron Samuels's friends' party. And I was also there as well, even though I can't really remember what I was, but I think I just dressed up like in a suit, I believe. I pretended to be like James Bond or something like that. Anyways, during Halloween, all of the plastics, they were wearing like leather dresses, I believe. Like Catherine was a mouse, and then Gretchen Wieners was something, and then Katie Heron pretended was a zombie bride. Like, and I'm not kidding. Like, she had, you know, the zombie teeth and the black hair and all that stuff. And so there was a lot of loud music and a lot of people playing beer pong and all that stuff. And, you know, and so what happened was Regina George, you know, started making out with Aaron Samuels at the party. And so that unfortunately made Katie, you know, very, very, that unfortunately hurt Katie. And she started walking out of the party. But then what happened was that she walked out of the party. Then there was this one guy that was sitting on one of those stair things that you find on stairs. And then he fell off and he was like, ah! That's funny. And then one guy was like, dude, that's a scary costume, bro. And so anyways, then what happened was, you know, Katie started heading to Janice's house. I don't know if it was Janice's house or Damien's house. Anyways, then what happened was, Katie told Janice and Damien what happened and all stuff. And then Janice told Katie what she had to do and all that stuff. But unfortunately, there was times where she kind of ran into problems, you know. And the reason I say problems is because, Katie was kind of going back to being part of the plastics. Then she was part of being with Janice and Damien and all that stuff. And then there was times where when she saw Aaron Samuels with Regina George, then she imagined attacking Regina George, you know, as a monkey. And then all the high school students in my high school started acting like African animals and all that stuff. So there was a lot of popular kid drama, if you will, you know. But thankfully for me, I was never part of it, you know. I was never really part of what was going on and all that stuff. I was just too busy, you know, hanging out with other people and, you know, and all that stuff. And so, during all of that, you know, Katie ran into another, she ran into this Indian guy named Kevin DeFore. I don't know if I really pronounced his name right, but anyway, he was like one of the mathletes, I believe. Now, the thing, if you don't know what a mathlete is somebody who competes in, you know, a math competition, knowing the most advanced math things, what not just basic math, but also like algebra, calculus, geometry, you know, all those, you know, different things, I believe. And so anyways, then what happened was, as Christmas came along, you know, I was just too busy, you know, hanging out with other people before, you know, Christmas break and all that stuff. Like, I was hanging out with other people and all that stuff. And then, so then what happened was, during Christmas time, right before Christmas break, you know, there was this one guy that showed up in my class dressed up as Santa Claus. And so what happened was, he was going, like, he was passing out, you know, a lot of Christmas gifts. And he was like, oh yeah, man, you know, oh, ho, 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 you know, fall for you, Glen Coco, you go, Glen Coco. And so he was just saying all that stuff. And so then what happened was, then Gretchen Wieners noticed she didn't get a gift. And then the guy started leaving. He's like, enough for Gretchen Wieners, bye. And then I also didn't get anything. And I was like, no, 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 no. And then again, I was like, no, 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 no. And so then what happened was that I screamed like that. And then he was like, and then my teacher's like, Stewart, go to Principal Duvall's office right now. And so unfortunately, just because I was saying no, 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 you know, I got sent to Principal Duvall's office. And I got 5 billion weeks of detention, too. Anyways, but the good news, though, is I survived and all that stuff. And, you know, I'm here. Anyways, then what happened, then there was a Christmas concert, you know, and Damien actually was in the concert along with the Plastics and Katie Heron and all that stuff. And so then what happened was, you know, Katie started finding out secrets about the Plastics, such as the fact that, you know, Regina George stole her parents' bedroom and Regina George got a nose job and all that stuff. And then, you know, just so many crazy things that were going on in a rich person household. Anyways, then they were, before Damien was performing one song that was performed by a female artist, and then a lot of people didn't like how he was sung, and people were throwing, like, food and shoes at him and all that stuff. And then what happened after Damien performed, then Kevin DePoor showed up, and he started singing, or rapping, as supposed, and he was going like, yo, 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 oh, you suck at MC, I'll take it, not serve, James Bond, third. Kevin DePoor, I'm on the bathroom floor, you know, and he's like, oh, Kevin G, you know, and then Principal Duvall was like, thank you, Kevin, that's enough, and then it was like, happy holidays, everybody, and then he also got detention as well, you know, along with me as well, and so what happened was Principal Duvall, you know, put him in detention, I believe, for throughout the whole school year, and so... And so anyways, then what happened was, then it was time for Katie Heron and the Plastics to perform Jingle Bell Rock, you know, and they were wearing those, you know, Santa Claus style dresses with the black high heeled boots and all that stuff. And they were wearing the Santa Claus hats, you know, and so they started dancing. I think they might have been dancing, you know, kind of like, you know, strippers, or I believe. I'm not kidding. They probably were, you know, even though I probably, in a lot of ways, they probably were dancing like those people, like you see in strip clubs and all that stuff. Anyways, you know, then they were dancing, and then what happened was then Gretchen Wieners destroyed, you know, the radio. And then what happened was she kicked the radio off the stage and it hit Jason right in the face. And so then what happened was then they started singing Jingle Bell Rock and all that stuff. And things turned out to be all right, you know. And I was actually in the audience as well. I was laughing throughout the whole thing, you know. And I know my parents told me not to go to it because I was grounded for a year because of what I did. But I went there anyway, you know. And I was just like, you know. And I even jumped into another popular kid's car and I sneaked into his trunk, you know. And I went, you know. And so, that was what happened, you know, during Christmas. And so I did have a very good Christmas and all that stuff, and I got some good presents, despite the fact that I was in detention. Anyways, then what happened was then, you know, a lot of strange things started happening in my high school. You know, there was, what happened was, you know, Janice put all these list of things that would start trending, you know. Like, what happened was, you know, Jason started making out with Regina in one of the gym closets, and all of a sudden, you know, Aaron Samuels, you know, was walking to his gym class, and he found out that, that Regina George was cheating on him with another guy, and all of a sudden Regina George was running in her underwear throughout the whole school. And then what happened was that the other guy that Regina was making out with, he was also in his brown tighties, I believe. I would say whitey tighties as well, but unfortunately they were not. I think they might have been brown, light brown boxers, I believe. And so, yeah, that what, and then what happened was then another person stole Katie Heron's purse, and then what happened was then Aaron caught, you know, Coach Carr making out with another girl, and anyways, it was just really bad and all that stuff, and then what happened was then, as you know, Regina George, you know, then was in, you know, taking a shower after her PE class. Then what happened was she actually got purple dots on her both of sides of her chest, I believe. And so then all of a sudden every girl started doing that, you know, and I was going to detention and on all my classes, and I was looking around going like, man, what is going on and all that stuff. And then and then I also found out too that Gretchen Wieners, or not Gretchen Wieners, but it might have been Gretchen Wieners and Karen that did this, and Katie as well. But what happened was they were trying to break down Regina, and so what happened was they started mixing foot cream and peppermint or something, you know. And so what happened was Regina's face started smelling like a foot, sadly. And then what happened, you know, was then she misheard that, you know, the bars that she was eating were actually found out that they were causing her to gain weight instead of lose weight, you know. And so all these crazy things were happening, you know, around. And the next part of the story will get even more crazier, I guarantee it. Sticks, you know, started cracking. And when I mean cracking, I don't mean the cracking where, you know, like cracking up laughing. I mean like cracking, like falling apart, you know. Because what happened, you know, was then, you know, like Gretchen Wieners, you know, like she started, you know, revealing more secrets to Katie. And then what happened was, then, you know, Regina started being more obsessed with, you know, those little candy bars that she was eating because she thought they were, you know, that she was losing weight, I believe. And then what happened, you know, then she found out about, you know, that someone told about, like, how she was cheating on Aaron Samuels. And then what happened was Karen, you know, thought going to Taco Bell, you know, would be fun too. But unfortunately, you know, she can't go to, Regina said that she couldn't go to Taco Bell because she was on an all-carb diet, whatever that means, you know. Even though I'm a guy, I don't really care about, you know, the stuff I eat, you know. Heck, I eat, sometimes when I go to Burger King for a school lunch, you know, I'll sometimes eat like a triple Whopper or sometimes a triple from Wendy's and all that stuff, you know. So diets don't necessarily matter in my book. Well, even though the Lord knows I do a lot of exercise, a lot, you know, my gym class. So, you know, so there you go. Anyways, then what happened, you know, was that, you know, Katie was trying to look for other talents that, you know, that Karen might have and all that stuff. And so then anyway, we finally get to the party that Katie threw, and unfortunately this type of party didn't necessarily go very well. And I will, and it started around like 7 p.m. and it's important to know that a lot of cars were there, and I actually snuck into one of the cars there as well. You know, I snuck into one of the popular kids' car without them even knowing. And so I was at the party acting crazy and all that stuff, and there was a lot of, you know, there was a lot of people drinking and all that stuff, and, you know, and people playing beer pong and all that, you know. It was just, you know, it was a crazy party. There was just like dance music going, like, oh. I mean, it was just a very, very crazy party. And all that stuff, you know, I mean, and, you know, and even, it was crazy, because, like, the whole high school was there. Heck, even Kevin Napoor was there, you know. I don't know how Kevin Napoor was there, but, like, he just found a way to get there. I don't know if he, like, stole a car to get there, or like, what, or if he, like, had his mom drove him there, or maybe some of his mathlete teammates drove him or something, but he just showed up, you know. I saw him walking on the sidewalk and being like, yo, I'm gonna get some tonight, you know. Oh yeah. And so he was walking on the sidewalk, and then all of a sudden one of the popular kids, you know, saw me in the truck and was like, and they were like, get out of my car, you know. And so they threw me on the ground, and I was like, ah. And so I landed on the grass, and finally I arrived at Katie Heron's party, and a lot of craziness and people dancing, people playing with African thingies and all that stuff, and things got broken and and all that stuff. And so then what happened was then you know, right as, you know, Katie was about to confess her love to Aaron Samuels, Regina actually caught, you know, Katie, and unfortunately she threw up on Aaron. You know, it's, you know, because she drank a whole lot at the party. Anyways, then what happened was then she left, you know, and unfortunately, you know, Janice found out, you know, and so both Katie and her, you know, were arguing and all that stuff, and unfortunately Damien had a curfew and all that stuff, and unfortunately Damien ended up getting in big bad trouble as well, and Janice got into more trouble, and Janice had no social life and all that stuff, and little did I know, you know, as a lot of people from my high school left the party, I was one of the last people that left, and it was like 4 o'clock in the morning, and so I left that party, you know, and I was going like, oh man, I got no ride. And so anyways, then, you know, I was, you know, running on the sidewalk, I was just trying to get home and all that stuff, and I didn't get home until I think 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and I believe, because it took me I think it took me 10 hours just to walk home. And man, I definitely gained a lot of muscle doing so, and you know, and I think a 3-pack as well, even though I don't necessarily know the human body very well. But anyways, but overall it was just a very crazy party. It was fun too. I even got to make out with a couple girls at the party too. Not one of the plastics, you know, but a lot of girls. Yes, you know, and, you know, it was a very crazy party, and Kevin Napoor was, you know, was acting like a fool and all that stuff. And so anyway, I got back to my house, and my mom was like, Stewart, you know, I've been worried sick about you, you know. And so then I ended up getting into more trouble, and then I was tired. I was tired when I got to school, and I was like, and so, you know, and so, everybody in the whole school, you know, was kind of hungover, you know, it was kind of bad, you know, but it was a very, very fun party. The Lord knows, though, unfortunately, what would happen next would be really, really bad and very epic at the same time as well. So anyway, then, as, you know, the school day was going really okay, I guess, you know, I was in my sex education class with Katie Heron, and unfortunately we had one of those awkward speeches by Coach Carr again, and he ended his lecture with saying, "You will get chlamydia." And die. And then I was just going like, oh my God, you know, because I'm pretty sure a lot of people at the party probably got that, you know. and unfortunately, you know, then Katie Heron, you know, got sent to Rob Principal Duvall's office, mainly because a lot of the staff at my high school found out about the burn book and all that stuff. And anyways, you know, well, you know, I stayed in that class, and oh my goodness, a lot of Coach Carr's lectures were not very good, and I think that class made me think about girls even more than what he was teaching. But anyways, then what happened was I heard, you know, papers being flown up in the air I didn't really know what it was. Maybe it was because maybe someone had the print, the copier on or something. Anyways, and then what happened was a lot of people got out. A lot of the people got out and people started reading everything in the burn book and all that stuff. And then a bunch of chaos started happening and all the girls started fighting, you know, and, you know, one was tackling another and then one was, you know, was kicking another or punching another. And then there were some guys that either ran away from the school or just started running back home, or one or a couple crazy and stupid guys, you know, watched, you know, and there was, and even Jason was watching as well, you know, in his dirty little mind and all that stuff. And then one of the staff members went to Principal Duvall's office and said, you know, the girls have gone wild and all that stuff. And then I was just walking around, just looking around, you know, and I was like, oh God, you know, I mean, it was like a riot, like you see in like Chicago or something like that, or in New York City, you know, I mean, like maybe there was like a riot that happened when George W. Bush was elected, you know, I mean, even though I know the election of 2004 is over and I know John Kerry lost, but maybe there was like another riot that, I mean, it was like something like that, except in my high school and all that stuff, you know. And then there was times I was looking around, I was going like, oh geez, you know. And then all of a sudden, you know, I got tackled myself, and then I ended up falling on my back, and then I had a hard time getting up. But then for some reason, Coach Carr helped me up, and then I also retreated as well. You know, I wasn't gonna stay. You know, otherwise I was gonna get tackled or get killed or something like that. You know, and then as the craziness went on, you know, Principal Duvall was going like, oh no, I did not leave the South Side for this, and so he even had a baseball bat in his hand, and you know. And unfortunately, like, all the girls went to the gymnasium and all that stuff. And you know, I was not there. I was long gone. You know, I ran out of that school like crazy. Like, I was even running on the sidewalk, you know, and all that stuff. Yeah, I'm pretty sure all the guys in my high school all left, you know. I mean, they all went home and they skipped school and all that stuff. I mean, it was just really... really, really wild, and, yeah, I mean, it was just very, 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 very wild, and even the Plastics even went up on stage to talk about their feelings, and to say sorry, and all that stuff, and even Regina George even found out about Katie's plan, and all that, yeah, and all that craziness, and, yeah, it was not good. I mean, it was really not good. I mean, it was like a riot in there. I mean, it was just crazy. And then what happened at the party, you know, was Jason and Gretchen Wieners were making out, you know, and then what happened was, you know, Gretchen Wieners actually slapped Jason in the face, and then Gretchen Wieners actually tripped, you know, when Gretchen Wieners, you know, wanted to talk to Jason, and she tripped, and then Jason was looking down going like, you know, and all that stuff. I mean, he probably had some dirty thoughts in his mind. I mean, if I were him, I'd probably have dirty thoughts about maybe making out with Gretchen Wieners too. I'd probably do the same thing, you know. But anyways, I just thought I would just tell you guys that, you know, just because that's just another detail that happened at Katie Heron's party. And Lord knows, too, after the riot, I'm pretty sure Coach Carr is going to get fired. And probably he's probably not going to have another job ever again either, you know. And, yeah, it was just awful. And then what happened was I heard that Regina was so mad that she ran out of the school. And what happened was, you know, Regina George, you know, she got hit by a bus, you know, and all that stuff, you know, and she hurt her back and her spine and all that stuff. I mean, My God. I mean, unfortunately, she unfortunately turned into like a very, she turned into a chihuahua with a brace, you know, just like how, you know, how those little puppy dogs, you know, have to have a brace when they have a bad back. That's unfortunately what Regina George turned into. I was even, you know, and then Katie Heron got grounded and all that stuff. I mean, nothing bad happened to me at all, but unfortunately oh my goodness. I mean, just a lot of craziness happened. I even had to go to the hospital just to even have my, just to have my shoulder redone. Even though I'm only 17 years old, you know, they had to redo my shoulder and all that stuff. They even, and you know, I had a hard time, you know, getting up at times just because I got tackled by so many people during the burn, I will just call it the burn book riot, you know, and all that stuff. I mean, it was just a very wild, but also a very important day as well. And anyways, Katie then went back to her skill of knowing math and all that stuff. And so anyways, long story short, the mathletes of my high school did well, and they proposingly won the championship. And so then what happened was Kevin DePoor went crazy, and he was like, "How do you like me now?" He ripped his shirt open, you know, and he was going like, "What's up? What's up?" You know, and he was just like acting so crazy and all that stuff. I mean, it was just very, very wild. And so then what happened was Kevin DePoor got into more trouble, and he got into even more detention as well. I mean, it was just wild. I mean, anyways, but I was at the spring fling as well. I mean, I was wearing a suit and all stuff. I was hitting on girls as usual, and then I would, you know, and then, you know, I was checking out some girls as well, and, you know, Aaron Samuels was there, and, you know, and, yeah, so long story short, nobody kind of, I mean, there was a lot of dancing. I mean, Damien had some good dance moves, and all that stuff, and, yeah, long story short, the Plastics broke up. Karen became a reporter, you know, noticing things about the weather. Then, you know, Gretchen Wiener started learning another language, and then Regina started playing lacrosse, I believe, and yeah, that is my school year in a nutshell. That is my whole school year in a nutshell. That is my whole school year in a nutshell. All right, so there you have it, you guys. That was my junior year at my high school. You know, a lot of crazy stuff happened, you know, from, you know, Katie Heron to the Plastics to the crazy parties, the crazy Halloween party, what happened during Christmas, and then what happened with the Plastics being cracked and Aaron Samuels and all that jazz. I mean, that is my whole high school year in a nutshell. I mean, I was kind of in the middle of it too. You know, I was there as well. I mean, I went to all the crazy parties and you know, and I snuck into popular kids' cars and without them knowing. And then I snuck into Regina George's house at times, you know, and I checked out Regina George as well, and Gretchen Wieners and Katie Heron, and, you know, and I mean, and yeah, I mean, that was my crazy high school in a nutshell, you know. And yeah, I mean, that was my school year in a nutshell. Anyways, in a lot of ways though, you know, I just hope this goes to a very valuable lesson. Anyway, the moral of my school year kind of was, you know, don't ever, you know, be caught in the middle of crazy stuff that happens. And anyways, you know, so that was just what happened. And oh no, Regina George and Gretchen Wieners and Kat, oh no, they caught me, man. You know, they caught me. They're outside my window, and I think there's a line of people coming. And anyway, if one of you guys, you know, sees this video journal, you know, I hope maybe in 10 years from now, you know, my name is Stewart, and I think they even broke my window now. You know, no. Anyway, there's a lot of popos out, you know, in front of my house and all this stuff. Anyway, bye bye everybody. I gotta go straighten this out, you know, cause the plastics are here and they're caught me making this, you know, video, and I gotta run you guys. Anyway, you know, and hopefully, you know, somebody, you know, has, you know, sees this video and all that stuff, you know. Bye bye everybody.